The PACI is down again as investors react to that rejection by Cypriot lawmakers of the tax on deposits over there. The PACI down 1.2% or 78 points. It's trading below the 6,400 level at 6,348.10. All the sub-indices are in the red, and market breadth very negative, 74 losers against only 19 gainers. Moving along now, time for our company call. We are joined by Mr. Isidro Consunji, President and CEO of DMCI Holdings. Good morning, sir.
Morning, Warren.
Thank you for joining us.
Welcome.
Well, it's a bad day for the market. But moving on, let's talk about your company. Of course, you're a big conglomerate. You've got your business interests in water, power, mining, and real estate. Let's talk about what you've done in 2012. Your full year figures aren't out yet, but based on your 9-month profit figures, it's up 12%. Will that be sustained for the year?
The indicated figure, we've closed the year around about 10 billion pesos on a net profit after tax for 2012. So it's a little bit less than what we thought. We were aiming at 10.5, yeah. Probably get about 10 billion.
Also, 2011, if I'm not mistaken, is 9.6 billion.
That's right.
Bottom line. So the growth in 2011 was 22%, very strong. So we won't be seeing that for 2012 figures.
No problem, not because the coal market was pretty bad. The real estate was quite good, and water was quite good. But nickel mining was also quite down. Commodities is quite down for 2012.
All right, let's talk about your coal mining operation, yeah. Semirara Mining. Of course, the big news there was that accident in February. The latest update on that, or what we got, was the DENR allowed you to actually start preparations for the resumption of actual coal mining. When will that actual coal mining start again?
Well, we've been given the go signal to pre-strip the mine, and we expect to be on coal somewhere around the end of the month or early April.
All right. With regards to the investigation, is there any update from government there?
I think it's pretty unfortunate, but the accident was caused by a slippage because of a very saturated high wall. Mm-hmm. But I think we're adopting some mitigating measures to make sure that it doesn't happen again. So we're working together with the DOE to make sure that we improve our safety measures.
Yes, but I understand also that as another department, the Labor Department, is also looking at what happened in February. Is there any new update from them?
I have no feedback from the DOE, the Department of Labor.
Yeah. Okay, but going back to, again, you mentioned earlier that the coal business has been a little bit hard up. You've got some of your competitors, Felix Mining, are reviewing their plans for coal operations, saying that the volatility in coal prices is really making things difficult. We noticed in your 9-month figures, the profits of Semirara Mining are already on a downtrend. What's your outlook for this year?
I think the negative effect of the prices of coal will be more than offset by the price by the, our rehabilitation of power. Kalaka 1 and Kalaka 2 are both finished rehabilitation, so you expect a much better yield on power income this year compared to last year. So we'll probably end up the year probably a little bit better than last year, or maybe the same, offsetting the effect of the negative prices of coal.
Okay, so the power business picking up the slack for your coal operation.
Yes.
Moving along now to your water business and your venture with Metro Pacific Investments, Maynilad. Of course, your new partner, Morobeni, you've got them in now after a prolonged negotiation period. So what's the next step? You wanted to bring in Morobeni so you could access cheap Japanese funding. When is that going to happen?
Well, normally, Japanese funding takes about a year or two to be able to access, and we wanted them because they normally give a 40-year loan, 10-year grace, and less than 1% interest rate. And this is the kind of money we need for Maynilad to be able to improve our wastewater treatment plant and other environmental measures. And the other aspect why we wanted the Marabeni is access to regional markets. So in Maynilad, we're about 92% already with water, coming from 68% 6 years ago or 5 years ago we came in. So we'll be saturated within 2 years. So we're using the network of Marubeni to grow regionally.
Yeah, of course, good news considering that your competitor here in Metro Manila, Manila Water, is also very active looking for opportunities in the region. But let's talk about your reduced economic interest in Maynila. It's going down by 16%. You're going to end up with about a quarter of the company. Will that affect the profit, your take from Maynila? Because right now, Maynila is one of the three big profit contributors for DMCI. So how will that affect that?
Well, they expect the Maynila income to still grow. So maybe our earnings will be slightly down, but the dividend yield in absolute terms should be more after we access the Japanese money. Because then the capex will be funded by Japanese credit, and therefore we have a lot more cash to be able to give more dividends out. So we're expecting a higher dividend payout.
Okay.
So after we access the Japanese money.
In a year or 2 years' time.
Yeah.
All right, so good news there also. Moving on now to your construction business. Yeah. Of course, the latest deal you struck with the Ortigas Group for the Viridian in Green Hills. Talk a bit about your other projects upcoming for 2013.
Yeah, well, we just finished Bloomberry. We're now full stream ahead on the expansion of Bloomberry, another 300 rooms, probably about 4 or 5 billion more. And then the Viridian Hotel from the Ortigas Group, which is about 50-story high-end luxury condominium. And then we got another job from the TransAsia Ayala joint venture, about a 3 billion project, 1x135 megawatt plant, second phase two, again in Calaca. So we think that when the PPP comes, there'll be a lot of opportunity for our construction group to grow this year.
Yeah, and you're also looking at the other infrastructure projects, the airports, and anything where you can actually get part of the contract.
Yes.
Let's talk a bit about your real estate business. We were talking about this earlier. You've got a lot of buildings going up, the Amarillis in South Triangle. Talk about competition here in Metro Manila. You've got a lot of you've got a lot of projects here in Manila, but so do a lot of the other real estate developers. And it's like almost everywhere you see, you look, there's a new building going up. So there has to be some concern whether or not all these units will be bought up.
We ask our competitors in the real estate. Everybody seems to be having a very good year. So whether it's true or not, but apparently it's true because we are having a very good year and all the reports we get very good year. Whether the market's saturated or not remains to be seen. I don't know. But we're concentrating at the end user market, mostly two bedrooms. And we're not in the investor market. So we think that the market in that segment is still underserved. So and we're putting our projects near high paying jobs. And so we're still getting, this year we're tracking slightly above our projection. So we're selling more than 500 units a month right now. So we should, if that continues, we should do more than what we projected for the year.
Okay, now moving back and again to your mining business.
Yes.
You said a little earlier that the nickel business is not doing too well.
Yeah.
You're also increasing your stake in Toledo.
Yeah.
So what's the logic there? Do you think that this is just a bad slump for the mining industry right now? You think that eventually the profitability will return?
Yeah, we believe so. DMCI Mining has been in nickel mining for 5 years, only as a mining contractor. So our contract expired. And we have developed a pretty good team. It's quite competitive. So we're looking at acquiring substantial shares in mining companies where we think we do a turnaround. Like Semarang is a turnaround, Maynila is a turnaround, acquisition of Calacas turnaround. So our acquisitions of these nickel mines is probably another turnaround. And it just happens that the companies we're buying already listed are listed abroad. So it's cheaper to buy listed companies abroad than do a greenfield today. So that's what we did. So.
Yeah, and considering that there is so much regulatory risk already,
that's right.
You really want to buy into something that's already up and running.
Yeah.
All right, so with that, we're going to end the interview. Thank you so much for joining us
this morning. Thank you very much, Maren. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Isidro Consunji, President and CEO of DMCI Holdings. Moving now to the foreign exchange market. As of 10:13 this morning, the peso is at 40.743 against the U.S. dollar. Volumes at $233 million so far. Back to Ron in the studio.